RSMB motion blur spazzes out on these fence posts. This building in the background looks like it's the software's default texture, as it's just a gray blob with a few specular reflections. This wouldn't be noticeable with even a little depth of field, which this shot lacks entirely. The garden plants are a bright, vibrant green, while the trees behind them have a duller, swampy color. I get that they're supposed to match the main character's house from the game, but some artistic license would have been preferred here, just to keep the art style consistent in this video. You can clearly see that this building over here is at the edge of the map. Tying into the depth of field sin, if you just had building-shaped blobs, it would help add more life into the shot without overcrowding it. The aforementioned default building has a bit of a stroke while it's on screen. It got a bit too excited about not having been altered. This doorknob is just a flat texture on the door. Zach's never getting out of this room for the rest of eternity. Not that he would leave anyway.
Now what I mean, now what I mean, notch, notch, now what I mean, say no more.
The footage of Windows 10 is inserted somewhat awkwardly into the shot. Perhaps panning to an isometric angle of Zach at the computer, then a match cut back to the monitor would have been a better choice. The desktop texture is a screenshot of a real Windows desktop, with a mosaic effect applied to add pixelation. However, when he clicks the folder 1 second later, the UI of the File Explorer is custom made, pixel perfect, and looks far better. Why not give this level of effort to the desktop? Also, the mouse doesn't have any pixelation applied to it. I appreciate the effort to make some creative title cards, but this looks like Zach is about to boot up a game called Random Encounters. Sayori's leg is clipping into her skirt. This isn't an upskirt, it's a through skirt. As usual, I'm gonna add 5 sins for the rest of the clipping in this video. The lighting makes it look as though Yuri is missing a chunk of her right foot. In this title screen, we see a Minecraft-esque reimagining of the Doki Doki Literature Club logo, but when Zach opens the game a few seconds earlier, the executable icon uses the original logo.
I'm so glad you're joining the Literature Club!
The top of Sayori's tie is inside her shirt in some shots, and outside it in others. Does she just keep adjusting it in between takes?
Club.
Hey, I never agreed to join.
You literally just agreed to join when you open up the game, my guy.
Oh wow, Sayori, who's your friend?
He's our club's newest member!
Half the time in this beginning scene, the girls' ties aren't even animated. There's some Eevee rendering artifacting going on here on the book and the desk. I'm actually gonna add 5 sins now, because there's quite a bit of artifacting in this video.
Friend, he's our club's newest member!
That's not set in stone.
The heavy ambient occlusion on the characters' mouths makes it look like no one has teeth. There's obviously a point light right in front of Zach, because he goes from well-lit to overexposed with a small turn of his head. It's difficult to see, but in some shots the top of the screen is white. Presumably these are more rendering issues with Eevee.
This is Monica, Yuri, and Atsuki!
I know the windows are like this in the game, but maybe there should have been some artistic license taken here, just to avoid a pure white void. The light gets brighter when the camera zooms in on Yuri. Why is Yuri the only one without a book here? She's like the most dedicated to the Literature Club out of anyone in the game. Maybe she left her copy of Clifford Goes to School at home.
And you already know me!
Sayori's arm turns into a pink triangle, thanks to the inexplicable lack of hard shading.
Welcome to our meeting, are you into reading? No need for being coy!
Monica's hair extensions are actually beard extensions. She's one gnarly gal. Yuri's hair collides with Zach's arm, which should kill its upward momentum, but it doesn't. How is Sayori so tall here? Please don't tell me. Ah!
We'll improve your uptake, have a freaking cupcake!
Monica breaks her wrist while lifting Zach's head. Natsuki's skirt briefly defies physics in this shot. While this cupcake model doesn't look too bad on its own, it doesn't mesh well with the Minecraft-inspired blocky art style in the rest of the video. There's floating AO shadows behind the window. I assume they were meant for light fixtures that didn't end up in the final render.
Time to write some poems, don't be scared to show them the festivals.
Monica, are you okay? Actually, I think we all know the answer to that question. I'm gonna use this time now to send the lack of thumbs on the girls' character models. It leads to weird-looking stuff like this.
You could help with baking,
or with banner making.
I'm not sure what's worse, that Natsuki pulls the platter through the desk, or that there's 6 nearly identical cupcake models in a row, or that the cupcakes come to a complete stop after being thrown in the air with over-exaggerated squash physics right beforehand, and despite that still stay on the tin platter. Yuri breaks her arms for a frame. Why is the window behind Sayori so bright, while the further one isn't?
And I'll walk home alone today. Maybe we're friends, maybe we're more. How can he love a simple girl next door?
Sayori suddenly going from lonely and sad to hopeful Disney princess is totally in character. But could we at least get, like, a transition of some sort? Unless Sayori has the quads and hamstrings of an Olympian, there is no way she could have been at this angle without falling backwards. Sayori is weighed down by the gravity of the situation.
Ah, waka waka!
And ends up breaking her leg.
I'm just not the type he's looking for.
Not only did Sayori draw this in under a second, but she somehow managed to draw a solid line on the crease of the paper? Sorry, I'm not buying it. Also, a pencil that thick couldn't even make lines that thin. Also, the drawing definitely wasn't there on the pages before she held the book up. Judging from where the drawing is positioned, we should absolutely be able to see some of it on the pages.
Hey, Sayori, doing okay?
Sayori's book has no visible spine when it's opened all the way. It looks like a giant chopping board.
I'm having a difficult day, I'd say you seem.
Monika pointing her arm at Sayori while Monika is only about a foot away is kind of an awkward acting choice. Plus, the angle of the shot makes it look like Monika is pointing at something at the wall behind Sayori, not at her.
You seem pretty lonely.
I'm not gonna sin the inconsistency of Monika suddenly holding a ball of string in between shots, since she's basically a god in this universe, but that string twirling animation around her finger looks pretty choppy.
All she wants are things back the way they've been.
This thought bubble is emanating from Zack's shoulder. Is his shoulder having these thoughts? Poor shoulder.
You.
All of these shots are underexposed to compensate for the red color grading, adding 3 sins for underexposed shots, and another for making me check that my screen brightness wasn't super low. The keys on the keyboard are a flat texture, so when the reflection shines on them, they seem to turn invisible. The translucent effect on the glass has some rendering issues, due to the lack of dark lighting in the back of the shot.
Just Monika.
What's with the ambient occlusion on the pupils? It looks like it has directional blur applied to it. The click is not synced with the sound effect. Also, you can see green edges on the desk toy and on Zack's arm left over from the computer screen being chroma keyed.
Wait, what happened to-
Who?
I know we already sent all the clipping, but Natsuki's skirt clipping gets a certified yikes from me. Natsuki is holding her manga here, but later we see her pull it off the shelf again.
Manga is my passion, don't you dare fashion.
Zack somehow gets dragged to the complete opposite side of the room by Natsuki. She must secretly be Mrs. Incredible to be able to reach her arm that far. Wait a minute, that manga isn't being read from right to left. It's a fake.
I found you, faker.
Maybe you should borrow these until tomorrow. Were you looking up my dress?
No, he wasn't, actually. While I am gonna send this for Natsuki's ignorance, I would have sent this much harder if it actually showed him look up her dress. While Natsuki does appear to be dangerous, Zack can always use his super sharp body bending attacks against her.
What about
me? Let's talk about me instead. I've been learning piano and I sing soprano.
Monika physically does not have enough fingers to play the piano. Also, Monika's hair goes right into her flesh, rather than connecting to the other bit of hair one pixel forward. Well, unless she just has a killer beard. This camera transition is not as smooth as it could have been.
Crush, it's sharp as a knife and twice the rock.
Yuri's knife has squash and stretch. Don't stretch knives, please. Be told, I just facepalmed so hard here, because I animated Natsuki for this scene, but forgot to use the correct render. This is embarrassing. Here's proof. Wait, doesn't everyone's leg stretch like rubber? The smoke in the background moves in short bursts for some reason. This exaggerated turn animation happened way too fast for me to process.
Natsuki is next, I'm deleting her too.
A stand-in thumb was added to Monika's hand just so that she could snap here.
Two. We don't need cupcakes or poems or tea. I only need you to love me.
The animators relied on you being too distracted by the tragic death of the cupcake model to not catch that this shot wasn't synced with the audio.
Hey, there's no one else in our way.
The YouTube plaque is now on a different wall than it was at the beginning of the video. Did Zack do some redecorating during an off-screen bathroom break?
Say right here, my dear, that you love me.
Why is Monika growing? She's an all-powerful god in the games universe, not in reality. Oh, I guess she can terraform too. Yikes, the people driving on this road are not gonna have a great time. That depth of field is so visually unpleasant thanks to Eevee. These next several shots look like the foreground is rendered, and the background is in the viewport. Wait a minute, why does Zack have his school clothes back on? Did Monika do that? Or did he just do a quick outfit swap as he was going up? Zack conveniently stops stumbling so he can make sure he's fine for the next shot. They must have reached the height limit, because even ambient occlusion doesn't work up here. Also, some of these background buildings are completely flat. So Monica can terraform at will, but is unable to stop Zack from getting the one thing that can destroy her. I think some of Natsuki's manga must be rubbing off her.
Well, look what the cat dragged in.
Wait, if Zack destroyed the entire computer, how are they back in the game? Or is this just the afterlife? The doors are closed in this shot, but are open in the rest. I'm gonna say this now so people don't get confused. This conclusion wasn't written by me. In conclusion, this video is pretty well done, with animation that keeps up with the energy of the song, the girl's innocence in the beginning is captured well, and the descent into madness felt well-paced, and aside from some consistency, clipping, and lighting nitpicks, it's still a good watch.